All right, here we go. SicEm365 Radio, 3:46 is the time, all the way up until 6 o'clock. Andrew Billings and his family have begun a foundation about giving back to where they are from here in Waco. He'll join us today around 5:20, I think it is. Mickey Spagnola, 430, DallasCowboys.com. And also, again, Trulin Elkins, part of their interview with us at 4 o'clock today. Craig's off the radar at 4:45, and Paul's top five, of course, at the very end of the show. Paul?
All right, so this is a graphic from Fox College Football, and it's two QBs of the 2000s versus QBs of the 2010s. I should have sent this to you, Armstrong, but let me see if I can get it to you real quick. But it kind of shows you the difference in quarterbacking that is gone over in the last decade. I'm sending this to Armstrong real quick so he can get it up so everyone can see it. So, yes, we lifted this from Fox College Football, but it's an interesting graphic, I thought. So, in the 2000s, here are the quarterbacks that won the Heisman Trophy. Chris Winkie, Eric Crouch, Carson Palmer, Jason White, Matt Leinart, Troy Smith, Tim Tebow, Sam Bradford. In the 2010s, Cam Newton, RG3, Johnny Manziel, Jameis Winston, Marcus Mariota, Lamar Jackson, Baker Mayfield, Kyler Murray, and Joe Burrow. And
so 9 of the 10 years in the 9 of the 10 were quarterbacks.
Yeah, but I mean, their question is, who would you want to roll with, which era? And I think it's kind of obvious, because if you look at the left column, there's only one genuinely successful NFL quarterback over there, and that's Carson Palmer. And we can debate the merits of Sam Bradford, you know, for whatever he was. Sure. But if you look on the right column, you've got Cam Newton, who was in the Super Bowl, Robert Griffin, who was a rookie of the year, Johnny Manziel was a bust, Jameis Winston, Marcus Mariota, to be determined. But, you know,
Jackson won an MVP.
Baker Mayfield looked like he's on the up. Kyler Murray looks like he's on the up. And Joe Burrow, again, played one season, looked okay, and then got hurt.
Is this a question about
who, NFL? Which side would you rather roll with in the NFL? Yeah.
In the NFL?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, well, yeah, clearly the right side, but if I'm winning college football games, there's way more national champions on the left side.
Yeah.
There's one on the right side, and that would be Burrow.
Three. You have three, because Cam Newton won one. And then
on the right side?
Yeah, and Jameis Winston won.
Where's Cam Newton on the right side?
He's on the very top. You can't see it. That paper's
okay.
In the way.
Well, yeah. Okay, sorry. No, never mind.
No, that's that. Okay, but no, well, okay. Paul, did Winkie win a national title?
You bet your booty he did.
Carson Palmer?
No.
Matt Leinart?
Leinart did, yeah.
May have won one or two. How many did Tebow win?
Tebow won two.
So they have actually more national championships at the college level on the left. It's still true, Craig. The left side has more rings and bling. But
it's not even a question, though. Like, it's not even a question. Like, I mean, I you know, who would you rather have in the NFL? I don't know. The guys, like the six starters in the NFL right now on the right side versus the entire left side that, you know, averaged 1.5 years in the entire, you know, in the league.
Yeah.
I mean, Jason White sniffed the NFL. Matt Leinart was a nobody.
Crouch
Troy Smith was a
anything.
Nobody. Crouch, nobody. Tebow was a nobody, but we just give him attention because he loves God and he's a nice guy. Bradford basically did nothing. Crouch, nothing. Winkie, nothing. I mean, there's
Winkie went 1-15.
Yeah, like, I mean, the only guy that did anything in the NFL worth talking about is Carson Palmer.
Yeah, he was pretty good, but you're right. He's the only one.
And on the right side, you've got four guys who are, top 10 superstars in the league right now.
And the last, in fact, okay, Newton obviously
was the biggest star before the Super Bowl collapse. He was like the biggest star in the NFL.
And is still a part of the league. RG3, we know his story. Winston, is he going to start?
I would think
in New Orleans?
You would think so.
He did play in Tampa. Mariota had a nice little run there with Tennessee. Lamar Jackson's an MVP guy, although he has to get better. Baker Mayfield, I think there was a lot of people that did not expect him to make it. He's taken Cleveland to the, you know, they didn't make the playoffs, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, I thought Kyler Murray was dynamic almost immediately, although still has to get better. And then Burrow, you know, he got hurt, so we don't know, but I'm sure he'll be just fine.
Yeah, if I'm going to win college games, though, I'm looking at that left side, because those guys, I mean, the right side wouldn't be bad either. There's definitely playoff guys and national championship guys, but, you know, some guys are just better college players, like Troy Smith, for example, Tim Tebow. I mean, that left side is guys who are just great college players. The right side is guys who are great college players and great NFL players.
Also depends on who you, what you. Now most everyone's running the wide open, throw the ball a lot, but it depends if you wanted to run with those players. If you had a team that ran the I or the option.
I'm going with option with Lamar Jackson before I'm going probably anybody else. I mean, I know Eric Crouch would be right at the top of that list too, but I just think Lamar Jackson probably would have, in the Nebraska offense that they ran. Imagine Lamar frickin' Jackson.
He'd have to be bigger. He'd have to definitely get thicker.
But like, I mean, come on.
Oh no. With all what they had.
Tebow would have been amazing.
Yeah, he would have won a Heisman in Nebraska. Lamar Jackson would have won a Heisman in Nebraska.
You know what though? I don't know if Tebow I could be wrong. This is not hating on him. He's a great college quarterback. Tebow in the option would have been pretty good, but would he have been able to run the speed option that they ran the triple?
I mean, he's not super fast. Because Crouch
could flat out go.
Yeah.
Frazier could go.
No, he wouldn't have been like the break it for 90 guy that they
had. But he would have been,
But Frost, I mean, Frost was not.
He was pretty athletic. He was definitely faster than Tebow.
But Tebow was still.
Yeah, he's in the secondary in the NFL for his career.
But, yeah, you know, even Mariota in something like that. That's very interesting.
I mean, it's cool to just kind of take a glimpse at a lot of quarterbacks, man.
That's 17, am I right? 17 of the 20 Heisman Trophy winners were quarterbacks.
Yeah.
Which, it's not like breaking news, but it seems to be too much.
Yeah, it is too much. But part of it is just because I think until recently, I think anybody ever called out the voting. It was just one of those things that, okay, well, he's the quarterback on the best team, or he's done this. It was, and look, most of it is quarterbacks and running backs because, you know, back in the day, look, if you're Earl Campbell, you're winning the Heisman Trophy. I mean, like, there's nobody else you should vote for in that instance. But I think there are times now where you have to look at the game and, you know, there are going to be people like Manti Te'o who got in and he came in second to Johnny Manziel. And there are guys who deserve to be in the discussion. And Dominican Sue, like Craig said the other day, should have won that Heisman. If not for the three quarterbacks that were in that thing, I think splitting up a lot of the vote, more people might have been like, oh, okay.
Colt McCoy was in that mix.
Yeah, Tebow was in it. And I think, and Bradford, right?
Right. The poll that I put up yesterday